This is the equation given by F. Okay. And you show, you saw a result about the stability of this equation in a complete Menger's probability symmetric spaces under Tm. You know that the Tm is the strongest T norm, and there is desirable to weaken this T norm. And here is a result on the stability of this equation complete probabilistic metric spaces under T norm of Huygens type. Here, you need for the probabilistic metric spaces proving the stability, and as in the preceding example, you need the definition of a uniform approximate of a solution, and after you see how a stability result under in these spaces in spaces under you see does look I would like to ask you some questions, please. Oh, no, I'm sorry. Okay. There is theorem 4. Is who can tell me? This is the equation where the approximate solution is defined. What means that F is an approximate solution for this equation in this theorem. This is the equation, and where an approximate solution appears, and where an exact solution does appear. An exact solution appears here in the statement of the theorem, but this is A. What does it mean? That A is an exact solution. What does it mean? That A is an exact solution of this equation. This means what? This means that this is the equation, if you want to say it on the screen. This is the equation, and A is an exact solution of this equation, means that A is a map. Oh. Is a map from S to X, X being the probabilistic This is our theorem. Here is phi, but our A is defined on S with values in X. Nu is a map from S. Of course, first F phi, this phi is defined of X with values and X. Okay, to fit this, and A is a solution, is an exact solution if is here, and F and the nu are given. The unknown is F here. And the fact that A is an exact solution means that it satisfies that
under the norm of time.
This is A.
For every X in S.
For the proving the stability.
If you know that A here, A is an exact solution, and what is the definition of an approximate solution? Where appears? Where does it appear? Here it is written that F
is an approximate solution
because it is not, you have not
equality here.
The relation between F and phi of,
it is not a relation of equality, but a relation of inequality.
F is close, is only approximate.
F is only approximately phi
is given by this inequality.
Okay?
And under this condition, and in other words, he's second supposed, and F is also probabilistic uniform approximate solution. We will see what this means. Every
approximate solution
is closed to an exact solution
in what sense?
So the distance between
that approximate and A, which is an exact solution,
satisfies this
inequality.
This means that A is close to F.
The probability of this
distance is,
okay?
And to prove this ability result,
what theorem in probability symmetric spaces could we apply? A fixed point theorem about what kind of contractions?
Look at the condition. This is suppose that this means that you have some conditions under which this implication
takes place. Segal contraction, because here it is exactly the condition of a Segal contraction, okay? And
here is a here appears a condition
Okay. We will use. Don't pretend to pretend you to make the whole proof. Just to point out the steps. Okay. You have to define a Menger space on the space of all functions defined on Y with values in Y. And here is the definition. I left you as an exercise something similar. There was indeed there two sets, because here G was defined not from X. Okay, here is the definition. I take directly without explanations. This is indeed a probabilistic metric on J, on Y, and here appears the condition of tending to 1 uniformly on S. Here is U, uniformly with U in S. Why? This condition is needed to guarantee that you have the starting. If you remember in the theorem of in the theorem about the existence of fixed point of Segal contractions in generalized metric spaces where the values were in delta plus. You, for the existence of the fixed point, you need a condition like this. There is x in x such that f of x is in d plus. Okay, if you remember the theorem, we work in generalized paramagnetic spaces, and to find fixed point for Segal contractions in this spaces, you need this condition for the existence of the fixed point. And this strange condition, this is tends uniformly on X, means that our operator has this condition from a static point. This has the role of X in our space. J dev, this is the operator J, is in D plus. Okay. At least you have to can read such a stability problem. And how can you prove that you have such a relation between the approximate function and an exact solution, approximate solution and exact solution? Why? How can you prove this inequality from here? Does it appear from here? Who can tell me? Such an inequality from here. Does it appear? I told you at the beginning of the preceding lecture that to obtain a stability result, you need not only a fixed point theorem. This theorem should be completed with an estimation relation. Okay? You remember how the stability, what the estimation relation, just to I'll write here on the table. In the case of second contraction in spaces under remember the stability pressure looks like that if F X X star of 1 minus I don't remember exactly everything like this does imply something greater than the n. Okay. This estimation, something is greater than bn, does imply the distance between this is it was here. Okay, such kind of implication. This is here due to our estimation relation. Okay, you know what happens when the distance between f and f of p, the distance, is greater than something, you know, greater than bn. No, here is something, is great. Then the distance between the fixed point, this point is p star, and p, this point, it's also of something is greater than b. And here a always is obtained by means as a fixed point of some operator. Okay, and here there's a fixed point of a Segal contraction. This is in this manner you can read a stability result. Here is something about the estimation. Okay, and here you have the definition of an approximate solution. And here's the distance between. Because here, when you have an estimation solution, we have a relation between the distance between the fixed point and the initial point. Okay. And another question. Can we obtain from a fixed for a stability result in a Menger space a stability result in random non-space? You have a stability result like this in a Menger space in doubt with T of T of Hajish type. Can you obtain a stability result in a random null space or not? If you want to obtain a stability result in a random null space, how can you proceed? How could you proceed? here is